and Minister Patricia Venus Henry. Join me every Sunday right here on the Tobago Inspirational Network at 9:30 p.m. for Stepping on the High Waters. Stay tuned because God is turning things around for us in this season. Good evening, viewers. It's a pleasure to be in your homes once again. Welcome to Stepping on the High Waters. And this evening, as you know, we are exploring going the distance in God. And on set with me is no other than Minister Erica Chance of the Wesleyan Holiness Church in Colla Hall. And we want you to explore with us as we go through this journey. As you know, it's conference time once again, November the 18th and the 19th, and we are just going through some of the revelation that God placed on our hearts to encourage you and infuse you, get you excited to be in the conference, to give you more understanding. And this is the time of visitation for us women and men too, but we are dealing with the women right now. And what God is saying at this hour is that He wants us to be hungry and thirsty for Him. He wants us to settle in Him. He wants us to be in a place because He wants to take us to the next level for what He's about to do with us. And we need to be in position. We need to know that we are called by God. We need to know and understand our giftings and our talents in God. And this is a season when God doesn't want us to be too busy body, too busy doing all sorts of things, but yet we are not presented at His feet. We are not in that place with Him that we can demonstrate Him truly to ourselves and others. And we are looking forward to His manifested presence in this hour. So viewers, share with us. Get yourself ready for the 18th and the 19th of this month. Yes, November is here once again. And we will let it be a November to remember. As I said before, those of you who are now hearing us for the first time, Women in Ministry, Laborers in the Vineyards, our conference is carded for the 18th and the 19th of this month, November. We will be at the Food and Nutrition Building in Canaan. Registration is $100. Our team is going the distance in God. Our speakers are Apostle Gemma Patricia Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center, Diego Martin, and also Apostle Diane Wilson of Victory in the Word International. Okay, she's also a part of Women of Destiny in Trinidad and Tobago, along with Pastor Phyllis Diamond. So we just want to give you those little information, write it down. Also, Friday night will be a grand time with you ladies. God has given us instruction to do something very special with you ladies. And on Friday night, we will be wearing black and white. What does black and white mean? Look it up. I want you to get excited on your own, beside us getting you excited. And Saturday all day, we will be in red. Fine red. If you don't have a red outfit, get some corsage or some roses or a necklace, something. We are going red. Amen. Registration $100. Food will be provided for you all. Amen. And you will just get the numbers on the screen, 781-3467-3997074. You could call Sister Marva at 731-5603. And also, you can also call and register at 639-6155, at Sister Anne's McCall Office, Triangle Building in Scarborough. So let's get busy. Some people already are calling and registering. Also, some are excited and they want to know if we are taking up seed offering. Yes, so into your purpose and destiny. We don't have a set figure, but we are allowing you to allow the Lord to tell you what figure to sow into yourself, into your future, into your purpose and destiny. So sit back and relax as we enter into this new level, in this new epic moment with the Lord. Minister Chance, last week we shared on Mary and Elizabeth. We shared about Mary going the distance. We shared about both Mary and Elizabeth going the distance until they bring forth. We shared how when they when they reach together, the baby leap forward, you know. We shared about the conception and, you know, which we shared about the birthing. What is the Lord saying to you today?
I have to laugh. Pastor Pat, you know, God is amazing.
Amen.
And the word God gave me is perseverance.
Perseverance, that's right.
And I keep saying, Lord, persevere, mm-hmm. persevere. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he took me back to a marathon. And, you know, we all start a marathon. Some persons run ahead.
Mm-hmm.
And that may be because they're physically fit.
Amen.
They have the stamina to do it.
That's right.
But there are those who have to take it one day chip, at a time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I pondered on it a little more today because this conversation was last night.
Mm-hmm.
And I pondered on it some more today. And I heard, the race is not for the swiftest, but for those that would endure to the end.
Yes.
Sisters, I want to say to you today, it is not where you've started.
Mm-hmm.
It is not how you would have started.
Hallelujah.
It is not when you would have started, but it's how you end this race.
Amen.
Remember, we talked about bumps.
Yes.
And if you don't encounter bumps, then there are no life experiences to share.
Mm-hmm.
From those bumps come so many experiences that you can now share with another sister to say, I've been there. A good sister sang, been there and done that.
Mm-hmm.
And she could have only sang that song because of her experience.
Yes.
I grew up in a home where my mother, she leaned a lot on old sayings, you know? And she would say at times, experience is the greatest teacher. And sometimes you hear them say these things and you wonder. But it is so true. If I have not experienced something, then I'm not able to identify with you. I am not able to hold your hand through it. I am not able to tell you, hold on, tomorrow would be a better day.
Amen.
And at this conference, it would be your tomorrow becoming that better day, Amen. That brighter day. Because sometimes in persevering, you get tired. If we look at, if we picture that marathon, while we're running along that route, we see their water stations. And what are those water stations for? To revive us.
Amen.
But as Christians, as women of God, when life hits us,
Amen.
What revives us?
Yes.
The word of God,
Amen.
Is what revives us. I mean, we sometimes say, God, I wish somebody could give me a word. But when we say that, let's not look for a physical person to give us it. Let's look to the Holy Spirit. Let's look to the word of God. The word that God says he honors above his
mm-hmm.
name. The word of God has so many life situations that could speak to even the situations we go through today. It would also teach us how to treat with situations as they arise. Because there was the situation of Abraham and Sarah. When God spoke to Abraham the first time, giving him the promise, okay, Sarah was in a tent preparing the meals.
Amen.
And when she heard it, she laughed. And imagine God heard the laugh from where he was. And when he said to her, you laugh, she said, no, I didn't laugh. Paraphrasing. But that particular story told us something. That even when God gives us a promise, let us not run ahead of the promise. Mm-hmm. But let us allow the very God that gave us the promise to bring that promise to pass.
Amen.
Many a times we get a word. Many a times prophets and pastors, teachers speak into our lives. And we run ahead of the very thing that they've spoken. Mm-hmm. What we need to do really is understanding that God is a God of timing. You understand? So that when the word comes, we need to find God. When we find God, we need to say, God, this is the word that came to me.
Amen.
We need to confirm that word.
Amen.
And when that word is confirmed, then the next thing we do is we stay in the presence of God. We ask God now, God, how do I prepare myself mm-hmm. for this word or this promise that you've
yes.
given to me? Because there must be a preparation. You cannot continue to live the same way and say that you're waiting on God for the promise.
Mm-hmm.
You have to prepare. Then if you don't prepare, preparing may mean turning your cup up. Preparing may mean you have to spend some time in praying and fasting.
Mm-hmm.
Preparing may mean spending some time in the word.
Amen.
And in so doing, you're preparing your mind, you're preparing your physical body, you're preparing your spirit for that thing,
yes.
to receive that thing. Because we must understand, and I'm not just saying women alone, all of us as children of God, we must understand that before that thing is passed apart, it
yes.
manifests in the natural.
Amen.
It will manifest spiritually.
Amen.
And if our spirits are not positioned
exactly.
with the Spirit of God,
exactly.
then we will not receive that thing
Amen.
That God has promised us.
Amen.
Ladies, gentlemen, if you're looking, remember, positioning is key. The Spirit of God speaks to our spirit, and our spirit then releases it to our minds,
mm-hmm.
and that's where we are able to comprehend it and bring it into the natural. Amen?
Mm. Similar to that, I want to say to them, establish a common ground with God. Do not wait until the days of the conference to come to receive in a particular way, because you might be limited. You might receive, there might be limits to your receiving because of the fact that the weeks went by, the days went by, and you did not prepare. So all those who think that they need to fast, because you come in hungry and thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
Now, those 2 days going to be very dynamic days. So you have to gear up yourself, get yourself prepared, your mind, your spirit, soul. Everything about you must be prepared. And encourage a sister. Encourage some sisters. Don't settle for one sister. You know the sisters who are hungry and thirsty. So you have to begin to spend quality time in God. Yes, you've been doing it, but get deeper.
Amen.
Get deeper. Remember, it's going the distance.
Mm-hmm.
So you are praying and fasting for God to give you understanding. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So when we come together Friday and Saturday,
mm-hmm.
what the Lord wants to happen must happen.
Amen.
And you must have your full course meal.
Amen.
You must not leave there half full like your gas tank. So if you put in $20, you'll get $20 gas. If you're putting 60, it's 60 you're going to get.
Amen.
Do not look at Adora, who may put in $300 gas. So she's going the distance for $300 because she had spent 6 months, 3 weeks, whatever, fasting before the Lord, going down before the Lord, worshiping the Lord, giving him praise and thanks, just giving him steady worship for those bold days.
Right.
Now, if you did not put in that time with the Lord, do not expect to get all that you required, all that God had in his jar waiting for you to receive. That means you have to go another distance again
yes.
to get what you're supposed to get before. Amen? So, ladies, I am begging you, please, get yourself in position. Position yourself. So when you come on those bold days, hungry and thirsty, you would get your full course meal.
Yes.
Full course meal. Don't fill up your belly with all kind of foolishness. Foolishness meaning gossip, old talk, or tiredness, overworking yourself, mm-hmm. unnecessary, going here, there, and everywhere.
That's right.
Spend that time, because remember we are saying we are ushering you into purpose and destiny. Amen? So there is a requirement, there are instructions. You need to fill up yourself properly. Get yourself ready, nourish up your body, straighten up your calves, straighten up your mind, your shoulders, your whole body. So when you come on those 2 days, you will have energy to burn. Amen?
And even as you talk about that, the strengthening, you know, something just dropped into my spirit, Pastor Pat. It may mean a purging.
Amen.
Because, you know,
hallelujah.
You can't.
Because we're leaping forward, right? We're leaping forward.
I am hearing new wine in old vessels.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, this is a word God would have given me like 2-3 years ago.
Mm.
You know, you cannot pour new wine into old wineskins.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to do some cleaning.
Yeah, all right.
And it may mean the purging of our entire minds.
Yes.
We might have been gathering stuff,
mm-hmm.
but now is the time to purge. If mm-hmm. we're talking about birthing into purpose and destiny, we need to shed some load.
Yes.
We need to become light.
That's right.
So that when we get into that place, mm-hmm. God has room. God is able to fill us.
Oh, yes.
If we have a cup and we fill that cup with juice, all right? And for 1 week, we only sip in that juice. And when Saturday time comes to get juice again, we pour new juice on that old juice. What happens? The new juice will spoil.
Amen.
We would not be able to use it.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, sisters, let's look, how the simple things in life relate to God things.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to understand that. We need to start looking at life differently. We need to look at how we do things in our own homes.
Mm-hmm.
And when we understand what we do and why we do it, then we would understand clearly why we do what we do for God and how we do it. And it would also bring us to the place of doing things in earnesty, in love, and excitement for God. Because the same enthusiasm you would use to do the natural things, we will have that hunger and thirst for the spiritual things of God.
Mm-hmm.
So let's purge. Let's empty ourselves. Wash our buckets, mm-hmm. or cups. If it's a cup you have, make sure it's clean. If it's a tin pan, make sure it's clean. Whatever is your vessel, make sure it is cleaned and turned up ready for God to pour in. And make sure your ignition switch working good so that as God pour in that new diesel, that new gasoline, whether it's lead free, super, whatever it is you're using in that engine, when you turn that ignition, man, you're ready to go and your exhaust blowing easy and nice.
Yes, right.
So you're ready to go to the next level in God.
That's right. And just as we have protocol in the kingdom, protocol in the workplace,
amen.
Protocol in the church, there is protocol in yourself.
That's right.
There is protocol dealing with yourself.
That's
sisters.
Right.
That means there are things that we're not supposed to do. Things
That's
that we need to get rid of.
That's right.
Things that should not come out from our mouth.
Amen.
And as you were talking about purging yourself, that came to me. You understand me? We need to get with the program.
Mm-hmm.
We need to get with the program. So as you purge yourself, you begin purging yourself from now on, that means when you come ready to feast at the table,
amen.
That God set and prepared for you. Amen? And I remember some time ago, I shared it on Stepping on the High Waters a few times, when the late Sister Johnny, Claudine Johnny, she was giving us an example of a group of ladies, they were taking a walk. And she said when they reach a certain distance and they look back, some of the ladies were where they began, some a little way from where they started, and they decided to go the distance. When they reached, now they turned back now and went and bring forward those that were left behind, who could not make it. And there were those who did come up a little bit, mm-hmm. and there were those who were still lagging. And those who, they knew that their time, they couldn't make it, they said, go ahead, we will come, go ahead, you go ahead, and we will take our time and come. But even if you are taking your time to come, still come and get infused. Still come Friday and Saturday and get infused. Mm-hmm. So that will help, and you will get the juice now, mm-hmm. to go another distance, mm-hmm. further than where you were. Amen? Amen. So ladies, we are here again. Those of you who are now tuning in, this is our 23rd conference, going the distance in God. I'm your host, Patricia Venus Henry from Divine Restoration Worship Tabernacle, Palm Eagles Drive, Crown Point. And we are here bringing you updates and highlights from the conference that will be coming up on the 18th and the 19th of this month. Yes, November is here. Yes, the conference is here again. And our two speakers are Apostle Gemma Patricia Duncan of Divine Destiny and Apostle Diane Wilson of Victory in the Word in Trinidad. She's also a part of Women of Destiny. Amen. And we are here gathering you. We are drawing you. And another thing the Lord dropped in my spirit a little while ago while she was talking about purging, be your brother, your sister's keeper.
Amen.
Look for some sisters to bring. Don't just say, you see me, I'm not bothering with anybody. No. Love your neighbor as yourself. So find some women and get them excited to come. There are those who may not be able to pay the money, but you, if the Lord pray about it and allow the Lord to lead you. If he sent you to Sister Gray, to say, Sister Gray, can you sponsor two ladies? Sister Martha, can you sponsor two ladies? Mm-hmm. They are hungry and thirsty, and they would like to be a part of this conference at the Food and Nutrition Building. You can do that. Your blessing is very, very much in sure from the Lord. So you can do that. Yes, we were talking about it's a leaping forward. We were sharing that our vessels supposed to be clean. So we are preparing from now for those 2 days where these ministers, and I understand, I got a buddy with me and told me that there are some Elizabeths from Trinidad, some mothers in the faith who ran the distance for so many years, up in their 70s, are coming to this conference. My God, Sister Erica, it would be an explosion of freshness. Amen.
Mothers of mothers.
Oh, God is doing something wonderful, something great. We don't understand what exactly he is doing.
That's right.
Up to the time, but guess what? He is doing something with the women in Tobago. Last week we went to Aglo International. Some of you know it as Women's Aglo. And my God, it was awesome. Women came out in their numbers from far and wide. And Tobagonians, do not do like what happened in Aglo, where endless women from the Caribbean islands, Trinidad, a great number from Trinidad and up the coast, came out and take what we supposed to get. For too long we are doing that. It's not that we're selfish, though we want them to come in abundance, but please come and get some nourishment. Your plant, which is your body, need nourishment. Now time flies fast, Pastor Erica, so say a few words.
Ladies, I leave you with this afternoon.
Hallelujah.
Remember Ruth. Remember Naomi.
Remember the reward in the end.
Remember the reward in the end. But I want to say this to you. Naomi was going back to what she knew as home. Mm-hmm. Where she knew, where she was very sure, mm-hmm. sustenance would come for the rest of her life. But because of her connection with Ruth, all right, she had two daughters-in-laws, but only one, Only one grasped the vision.
Amen.
And that one was Ruth. And Ruth followed Naomi, not because she knew what they were going to, you know, because she understood and knew that, listen, if this lady, Naomi, is going back to her place of birth, then I am going to go with her, because there must be something significant there that I can receive from her.
Yeah.
So whomever is your Naomi today, I pray, if you have lost connection, please reconnect.
Amen.
And follow your Naomi to your destiny.
Amen.
God bless you.
Yes, and as she says that, remember too, when the angel of the Lord visited Mary, and he told Mary, your cousin Elizabeth is in the same journey. Mary went forthwith and visited Elizabeth.
That's correct.
And when the boat came under the same space, the babies leaped in her womb.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? She knew exactly that the Lord had done it. The Lord did something awesome.
Amen.
Amen. That was a spiritual connection, a physical connection, a covenant connection, however you want to put it. Do not miss your new walk in the Lord.
Amen.
As she said, do not miss in your new walk. Ladies, if you cannot get on to meet myself, Sister Anne or Sister Marva, you can also call Minister Erica here at 360-72-7323. Amen. So remember, put it on your calendar. Let those days be free. The 18th and the 19th of November, the water has already been stirred. Time to jump in it. Time to swim to your destination. So to God be the glory, great things he has done and great thing he has on that table set out for us to come and feast. Come and feast. Come and drink of that new wine. Get excited. Get excited.
Amen.
Get excited. This is Hallelujah. The hour of visitation.
Yes.
This is the time you've been waiting for.
Yes.
For a long period of time, you've been crying out.
Amen.
And you've been asking God some questions. When will it happen, Lord? When will it happen, Lord?
Mm.
Why isn't it happening? And the Lord is saying that so many times he organized the stirring of the waters, and many of us are not jumping in.
That's right.
It is here again. Jump in.
Amen.
Jump in.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Remember, you can call 639-6155, Sister Anne McCall, and register there. Amen.
Amen.
Bye for now. Bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.